Hello, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makerdemy. This is Nidhi and I'm a part of the instructor team at Makerdemy. In this episode, we will learn about the Azure Sphere. Before getting started with Azure Sphere, let us first discuss in brief about Azure. Azure is a cloud computing platform provided by Microsoft. Azure can be used for building, testing, deploying, and managing applications and services using Microsoft's cloud infrastructure. Azure Sphere was released by Microsoft in the year 2018, specifically for IoT applications. Microsoft Azure Sphere provides cloud support and security solutions for IoT devices. In Azure Sphere, three components are working as one. First is a secured microcontroller unit that comprises built-in security and built-in connectivity. Next is a secured operating system that is Linux-based, having secured application containers and cloud services inbuilt. The last component is cloud security, which handles software updates, detects emerging threats, and provides authentication. Now we will discuss these primary components one by one for more understanding. The architecture of an Azure Sphere MCU includes multiple cores, including secure processors like the ARM's Cortex-A family. Azure Sphere hardware comes with Wi-Fi, Ethernet, Bluetooth, and cellular connectivity. Azure Sphere hardware architecture includes Microsoft security subsystem called Pluton, which handles device security, high-level application processor cores, real-time processor cores, integrated RAM and flash, compartmentalization to provide high security. The next component, Azure Sphere OS, is a Linux-based operating system provided by Microsoft. The Azure Sphere OS includes Microsoft written security components and support for secure containers. Apart from licensed versions of the Linux kernel, some portions of Azure Sphere OS are open source. The architecture of Azure Sphere OS is multi-layered to ensure the maximum security possible. Layers of architecture include Azure Sphere MCU hardware layer, OS layer 1 for security monitoring. It runs below the kernel to guard the overall device. OS layer 2 is a high-level operating system Linux kernel. It is responsible for running the main OS of the Azure Sphere device. OS layer 3 is an on-chip cloud service responsible for authentication and connection to Azure Sphere security service and also provides updates. OS layer 4 is an app container. Real-time applications and high-level applications are executed in this layer. Azure Sphere OS is specifically designed for Azure Sphere devices. Azure Sphere devices support no other Linux-based operating system like Ubuntu. This is because Azure Sphere OS provides a secured environment. Microsoft creates this secured environment by customizing the Linux kernel. The Azure Sphere OS kernel is cut short to run within RAM of Azure Sphere device. Hence, it is very small compared to other operating systems like Ubuntu. The third component, cloud security, is provided by Azure Sphere Security Service, also known as AS3. This component provides the root of trust for secure connection of IoT devices built with Azure Sphere. The AS3 is responsible for providing authentication and pushing updates. All Azure Sphere devices are registered with AS3 at the time of manufacturing. When an Azure Sphere device is switched on, it will connect with AS3 service so that AS3 can push down an Azure Sphere OS and application updates. Azure Sphere has the following features. Azure uses the defense-in-depth approach for its security. This provides protection and guard devices against threats. Deployment flexibility for securing existing IoT equipment and providing protection to new upcoming IoT products. Over-the-air updates, error reporting, and automatic security updates. With this, it is clear that providing high security is the primary objective of Azure Sphere. Let us now have a look at the basic properties of a highly secured device which is embedded in Azure Sphere. Hardware root of trust. Azure Sphere MCU is immune to malware attacks and threats. Hardware, firmware, and software of Azure Sphere are protected, thereby providing a trusted computing base. Certificate-based authentication. Azure Sphere uses digital certificates for identification. Renewable security. Azure Sphere adds a protection layer to protect upcoming new IoT devices. Failure reporting. Azure Sphere handles and logs errors. Instead of getting stuck solving I/O errors, drivers issues, and deployment failures, Azure Sphere end-to-end solution can help businesses create secure and interconnected devices which are controlled, updated, maintained, and monitored remotely. To start using Azure Sphere, we need to follow these three steps. Buy hardware development kit and install Azure Sphere. Read documentation and quick start to learn more. Build your first application. Please visit the resources in the video description to get links for getting started with Azure Sphere and build your first application. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.